stream cipher, because you will find a huge use of this random number generators in stream cipher. So what is stream cipher? It is a process, you know, process masses bit by bit as a stream. That means at the time of encryption, the masses, whatever masses, text, image, whatever you have as masses, that will be taken bit by bit by the algorithm and encrypted. That is what it is saying. Then, or you know, sometimes it may, it may be a set of bit at a time, okay, a byte at a time, it can be, okay. Then have a pseudo random key stream, so it must have a pseudo random key stream, that means a random number generator kind of, okay. Then often it is combined jar with plaintext bit. So most of the many algorithms you will find where jar operation is used to, you know, combine the plaintext bit with key stream bits, you know, bit by bit, and generating the cipher. Then randomness of stream key destroys the statistically properties in the masses. Like, what is that? If you see one image, so what happens in an image, the, you know, every consecutive pixels are quite same, right? Because if there is a red color in an image, so red color will not be for only one pixel, then it will not be visible. At least a, you know, region will be red, and in that region there can be, you know, 1,000 pixels, and all thousands are, you know, red. So the, you know, there is similarity among them. Okay. So, but the stream cipher destroys that statistical properties that that is called correlation here. Okay, in the masses. Okay. So one example is given here how the cipher is generated. It can be generated like, you know, CI is the cipher, you know, for the ith bit. Equal to ith bit in the masses, jar with stream key, ith bit of the stream key. Okay, so this is a simple way of doing it, and I have already shown in some previous discussion that how using XOR we can have a cipher and we can get the message back if we know the, you know, stream key. But must never reuse stream key. So it is saying that you should never reuse a stream key for multiple masses. Otherwise, it can be recover the message. All right, okay, but there is a different, see, a book cipher, and there is a different example of such attacks, that if you have same key, if you use same key to encrypt multiple messages, and the attacker have all these encrypted messages together, then the attacker can, it is possible that attacker can analyze what was your key stream. Okay, so this is about an overview of stream cipher. Then if you look stream cipher architecture roughly, you know, what I was telling you, it looks like this. So plaintext byte stream, so here you see it is writing byte and not writing bit stream. Okay, no problem. So that means this is taking one byte at a time. One byte is coming, and 8-bit is coming, and we are doing jar operation here. Okay, one byte of masses, one byte of small k, and which is the key stream. Okay, and we are getting the cipher C as the output. And on the other receiver side, if you see, there is a decryption algorithm. It is equally simple, same process. We have the same pseudo random byte generator. You have the same k here with the, you know, recipient. And he used that key to generate the key stream, okay, here. And we have the ciphertext, and he takes one byte of the ciphertext, and this key gives one byte at a time, and jar them bitwise and gets back the plaintext byte stream. Okay, so you can understand how a, you know, simplest stream cipher works. Okay. Then properties of stream cipher. Same design, some design considerations are long period with no repetition. This is equally important for the stream cipher. It should be statistically random, depends on large enough key, large linear complexity. Then I think you understand. I am not discussing it, you know, these things in detail. Most of the things you know already, right? It depends on large enough key. That means the key what you are using, that key K, should be large enough so that, you know, it should not be breakable using brute force, or it should not be guessable by any other method by the attacker. Okay, then it should have a large linear complexity. That means if you linearly going to, you know, analyze the period or anything else, okay, it should have a very large complexity. That means you have to analyze for, say, few crores of bit, millions of bit at a time. Then only you can do that analysis. Okay, then properly designed can be as secure as a block cipher with same size of key. If you, you know, design a proper stream cipher, it can be as secure as a block cipher. Okay, and if you even if you have the same size of the key, okay, but usually simpler and faster. But you know, usually the stream ciphers are simpler and faster as compared to the block cipher.